Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about pastel hair care. My hair right now is pretty faded. This is about as faded as I let it get before I re-dye my hair. So it's on my mind right now. I just figured I would talk with you guys about it while I'm thinking about it myself. So I have had this pastel pink hair for about a year now. Over that course of time, I've tried a ton of different products, a ton of different coloring methods to figure out what works best for me to maintain, to help my hair fade smoothly and beautifully, and I am ready to share all of my tips and tricks with you guys. So let's just dive right into it. I don't go to the salon to get my pastel hair taken care of. I do all of these things at home because it does require quite a bit of maintenance and it would get really expensive if you were trying to do all of this at home. So even though I am a professional hairstylist, I get the struggle. I get how expensive it would be, and making appointments that often is just not that realistic for the average person. So the first thing that I want to talk about are shampoos and conditioners that have color dye in them. These two are my favorite. I've talked about this one before. This is the Viral Pastel Light Pink Color Wash by Celeb Luxury. You can purchase this on Amazon as well. And it's not just pink. They have a ton of other colors. And I'll show you guys some of the other options that they have up here. I buy the light pink shade. I used to dye my entire hair pink with this shampoo. And I'll link that video down below. It still is definitely an option for if you're wanting to dye your hair at home. But for the most part, I mainly just use this in the shower, like as a shampoo, because I found some other methods that work a little bit more consistently. And the tone of pink that this guy has, it's got a little bit more purple in it than I like. I like my pink to be a little bit more peachy toned than purpley toned. So I really, really, really like this guy. It has a really good color tone to it. And this is a conditioner. Technically, it's a cleanditioner, which is like a cleansing conditioner. So you don't have to use a shampoo. You can just use this. The only problem that I found is then you go through this so fast because you use a lot of it because you want to get it throughout your whole hair. You need it on your roots to like clean. You need it on your ends to, you know, put that color back in. And so what I kind of do is I'll use this guy on dry hair and apply it to my roots right before I get into the shower. And then once I hop in the shower, I get it wet, suds it up a little bit, which disperses the product so that if I've missed anywhere, it kind of like fills in the spaces. Then I let it sit for a minute and like wash the rest of my body. Then I'll rinse all of that out and finish with this conditioner, the cleanditioner. And that just kind of makes sure that like the color is also going to be refreshed on my ends as well. And so I apply this as a conditioner. I only use these shampoos and conditioners with dyes in them when my hair is fading. I don't need to use them every single time that I wash my hair. So when I'm not using these products, then I'm using just like a traditional shampoo and conditioner. I'll link the ones that I love down in the description box. So that's how I do my pastel hair care in the shower. The way that I actually dye my hair, I use Pulp Riot, and I found some of like the Pulp Riot color on Amazon, and I have it linked in the description box below. I use the shade Cupid, but it is a very, very bright pink. And so I like to dilute it because it's too bright of a pink for me. So what I end up doing is I mix a little teeny bit of this color in to a deep conditioning treatment, kind of like this one from Wella. And I just make my own dye using deep conditioner and this. The ratio is seriously like a tablespoon of this to a cup or more of the conditioner. So it's not like half and half. And this doesn't have any developer in it. It's just conditioner. All that this is doing is diluting this product so that I can get it dispersed throughout my hair and so that it's not as bright of a pink, because I like pastel pink, not this like vibrant neon hot pink, which is what this color looks like. So I dilute the color and make it more manageable by mixing it with a deep conditioner and then apply it on dry hair. Let it process for like an hour. Usually you could do it for like 10-15 minutes, but I like to let it sit on there because it's helping my hair at the same time. It's acting like a deep conditioning treatment, so it's healthy for my hair, so why not just let it sit for like a long time? So I usually let it sit for an entire TV show, and then I'll go and wash my hair out afterwards. About once every 4 months, I will dye my hair. Now that I figured out how to maintain it and to prevent it from fading, I don't have to dye my hair as often. So yeah, that's the formula. This is what I use when I'm actually going to like full-blown dye my hair. The other thing that I like to do is have clip-in extensions like this guy that are colored using this same method that I can put in my hair when my hair is starting to fade. So for example, I'll just throw some of these in real quick. What this does, you'll be able to see with just one, it just kind of like refreshes your hair and makes it look a lot more pink and like it has some dimension. That's just with one, and normally I'll do like a full set of this color, so like the rest of them are in here, but anyway, I'm just showing you for an example. But you can see like there's some bright pink, or not bright pink, but brighter pink pieces woven in throughout my hair. So when you initially look at me, this side just kind of looks a little bit apricot or not very like pink, but this side looks a lot more pink. So it tricks the eye of a person that's looking at you to think that your whole hair is a lot more pastel or like vibrant in color than it actually is as it's starting to fade. So my clip-in extensions that are dyed to match are like my secret agent, my trick to making it look like my hair is still pink as it's starting to fade. So that's one of my all-time favorite tricks. It does cost a little bit more money because you have to buy clip-in extensions, but for me, it's worth it because with clip-in extensions, you get to take them out at the end of the night, and so they don't get dirty and you don't have to wash them as much, and so the color stays a lot more vibrant. So they're just super easy to throw into your hair when your hair is starting to feel not as pastel, if that kind of makes sense. Some other tips for just pastel hair maintenance are: try to not wash your hair as often, find a dry shampoo that you love, use it, try to only wash your hair like once or twice a week, because every time you wash your hair, your color will fade just slightly. So it's inevitable, it's going to happen. So the least you can wash your hair, the better. So find a dry shampoo. My favorite is Batiste, but I've done an entire blog post on reviewing 21 different dry shampoos. So if you're curious, or if you haven't found one that works for you, you can check that out. The link for that will be down in the description box below as well. So try not to wash your hair as often. Try to only use heat very sparingly. Personally, what I do is I let my hair air dry, then I pick one method of heat, and I do that one thing. So I curl my hair once, and then I won't touch it until I wash my hair and need to style it again later. So if you're going to like straighten it, just straighten it and then try and keep it straight the whole rest of the time, or use other types of styling like braids or ponytails, or throw your hair in a hat or like something like that, so that you don't have to use heat on it every single day. The other tip that I have is if you are going to go to the pool or the ocean, or if your hair is gonna get wet, load your hair up with an oil or a serum or a conditioner, a leave-in conditioner, something along those hydrating, nourishing, you know, like in that realm, so that when your hair gets wet, like the main thing that's like in your cuticle is something nourishing and hydrating that's going to be good for your hair, instead of something that will strip your color like chlorinated water or salt water or something like that. For example, if I was going to the pool, I just take a good handful of coconut oil, and I just like work it through my ends, especially work it through my hair. Even though it's like super greasy and oily looking, I'll just throw it into a braid and then go into the water, and my hair ends up feeling way softer and doesn't fade as much when I do it that way, instead of just going into the water with dry hair. Those are my tips for you guys. I just wanted to encourage you guys, if you've been on the fence about trying pastel hair, nowadays there are just so many products that make it so easy that there's really no reason not to go forward with it. It isn't as high maintenance, or it doesn't fade as terribly as some might think if you use these tips and tricks. Feel free to ask me any questions if you think I haven't covered something down in the comments below. I'd love to reply to you guys. Don't forget to check out the links down in the description box below. Everything that I've talked about should be linked down there. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this video helped. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!